guys, Nader Animator here, and today I've got a story for you. So last spring, my family and I went on a carnival cruise. We had a wonderful time swimming in the Mayan ruins, chilling in Cozumel, relaxing aboard the ship, and of course, eating and enjoying the gift from heaven above, the wonderfully delicious Guy Fieri burgers. Not kidding, guys, I think I ate about two or three of those each day on the vacation. They're just so good! If you want to see the vacation in its entirety, I'll leave a link to the vlogs I made here or in the description. Anyways, as you can tell by the title of this video, this story is about a very special guest in particular.
Please excuse this interruption. May Travis Kitty Cat please come down to guest services at this time? Again, may Travis Kitty Cat please come down to guest services? Thank you.
That was the announcement that was broadcast on every speaker system on the ship. Yes, every one. At 4 o'clock in the morning! By the way, the dude's last name actually wasn't Kitty Cat. Obviously, I'm just using fake names for, you know, safety and privacy reasons and stuff like that. But also, I kind of forgot his name. I know it ended with a K and had a T in there somewhere, but I don't know. I don't really know that guy's name. But yeah, so that's that. So at this point, I was already kind of awake because for the last few days, I was setting my alarm at 5 o'clock a.m. so I could record the sunrise for my vlog each day. And my body just kind of knew that the time was close. However, the rest of my family in that tiny little room was fast asleep before this announcement went on. I heard some shuffling and some muffled mumbling and figured that we all just sort of shrugged it off. Maybe it was an accident. Maybe some kid was lost on the other side of the ship, or there was this new dumb employee who hit the wrong button, whatever. So I just shut my eyes and tried to relax and go back to sleep again until not more than 2 seconds later.
May Travis Kitty Cat please come down to guest services at this time. Again, may Travis Kitty Cat please come down to guest services or dial 999 to reach guest services. Thank you.
That happened, not kidding, a total of 4 more times that morning. At this point, I could hear my neighbors getting out of bed, babies started crying, and my stepdad just couldn't stop swearing. Just for a bit of context, my stepdad used to work on the Carnival cruise ship, so he knows how these things are supposed to be run. At this point, my entire family was wide awake, and we were all confused and upset as to what the heck was going on, but my stepdad, he was furious. I saw him angrily slip on his shoes and head straight to guest services. When my stepdad got there, he just stood in awe and shock as he saw a rebellious-looking teenager, an older-looking woman, and the captain of the ship himself having a pretty heated debate.
Oh, thank you so much for finding my grandson. I'm so sorry for causing a ruckus. I was looking for him everywhere on this ship, and I deeply apologize for everything that happened. I didn't mean for any of this to happen, really. I'm so sorry.
Obviously, the old lady seemed like she was just full of a bunch of crap, but at this point, my stepdad was just too tired and annoyed to really do anything, so defeatedly, he just headed back to the room.
So what happened?
Supposedly an old lady lost her grandson or something on the ship because she was drunk or something. I don't know. People are stupid.
And that was that for the rest of the vacation. Well, I mean, that's only sort of half true. We never heard anything on the speakers again and were able to get a decent amount of sleep that night, thank God. But the next day, rumors about Travis had spread across the ship like wildfire. No one really knew exactly who Travis was or what happened last night, so people were making all sorts of wild stories about him, and one of the stories I heard had Travis as a little 8-year-old kid who lost his parents because they were at some party and they forgot to go look for him. I also heard that he was an 80-year-old man who drunkenly passed out on one of the outside decks and just woke up without his wife. But by far my favorite rumor would probably have to be the one that seemed the truest, where Travis was a rebellious teenager who was, of course, on vacation with his grandma, aunt, and 2 cousins. Apparently, Travis had found a rather attractive girl on the cruise ship and secretly snuck into her room that night. They hid under the covers and did some pretty non-advertiser-friendly things. Like play Fortnite instead of Minecraft. Huh. Oh man, and this guy, he became an absolute meme for the rest of the vacation. People with whiteboards on their doors were writing about them, comedians changed their shows to make references to him, and there was even talk of a "Where the Hell is Travis?" t-shirt. Man, I would pay good money to get that shirt. but probably one of the most hilarious things to happen, not only because of this situation, but on the entire cruise, would probably have to be when my stepdad interrupted a karaoke session to do this.
Now it's time for Cody! Cody!
Sorry, I don't mean to interrupt or anything. I just have a real quick question for everybody. Who and where the hell is Travis? Am I right?
So I guess the moral of the story is, if you have a problem, find an easier way to solve it that doesn't involve waking up over 2,000 people. Also, Travis, if you're watching this one, well, I just hope you're doing all right, buddy. Child support is expensive. And just like that, my first animated storytime video is complete. I hope you guys really enjoyed that, because I spent a lot of time making that. And now I know I said I would be posting every month or every 2 months, but obviously, if you've been keeping up with my Instagram and Twitters and stuff like that, you would know that I've been kind of way too busy for that. You know, I've been preparing for college and working 2 jobs, maybe 3 this summer now, and it's just, I have a lot on my plate. So I am going to be still posting on this channel and the Notebird, just not as frequently as a month or every 2 months or stuff like that. So make sure you're subscribed if you like this sort of content. And also, yeah, press a like, because I'm going to be making more storytime animation videos like this, because they're really, really cool. And I think I like them. I don't know. I like them. I don't know if you guys like them. I like them. But yeah, that's it. And I hope you guys have a good day. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Thank you for watching. I am Nader Animator, and I will see you guys next time. Good. Bye! Oh.